Father, we come here tonight, Lord, we just want to thank you. We thank you for waking us up this morning.
Yes, Lord.
My Heavenly Father, and we want to thank you for taking care of and watching over and keeping us safe, up until right now, my Heavenly Father. Father, we just want to thank you for allowing us to be able to come out to your house of prayer another way in the night. My Heavenly Father, and we ask that you keep our pastor and teacher, keep him strong, keep him safe, my Heavenly Father. My Heavenly Father, you know what he needs. And Father, my Heavenly Father, just keep your arms wrapped around.
Yes.
Give him strength, my Heavenly Father. My Heavenly Father, we just want to say thank you for everything that you have already done for this church, my Heavenly Father. My Heavenly Father, and we ask that you just help those that who is sick, my Heavenly Father. We ask that you have mercy. Those that are in nursing homes, those that are at home, my Heavenly Father. We ask that you have mercy on those that are locked up in prison, my Heavenly Father. My Heavenly Father, we ask that you just give them strength, my
Heavenly
Father.
Please, Lord Jesus.
Lord, we just want to tell you thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
And we just want to thank you for your word.
Yes,
but most of all, my Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for your darling Son, Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
You sent into this old sin sick world to save you. That's what we're about.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Again, we thank God for another day that he has spared us and brought us to the house of prayer once again. Take a look at his word and so we learn to help us in this walk of life. To God be the glory for the things he has done.
Yes.
Amen. Who's going to bring us up to date?
They let them know that they had seen him.
Mm-hmm.
They had touched him.
Right.
They had walked with him. So they were letting them know that he is real.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he is real. And we also said Jesus is to life what antibiotic is to infection.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, Jesus is a cure.
Yes.
He everything you need.
Mm-hmm.
Anything you need, he
can. Yes.
And we also learned after that we need a manifestation of Christ, of Jesus, in the church. In other words, the people that got to be real. You can't just say, you know, I go to church. You got to be saved.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you gotta be saved. You gotta be real. You gotta be true. Because the word tells God only to worship him in spirit and in truth.
Mm-hmm.
And we also learn fast that God is light, and in him there is no darkness at all.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if we truly got God in us, we don't go around thinking evil.
Mm-hmm.
We don't go around trying to destroy nobody's house.
Mm-hmm.
We don't, you know, be saying, putting our stuff on, you know, somebody just because we might be angry or biting our life.
Mm-hmm.
And as Christians, we're supposed to be different from the world.
Mm-hmm.
And we're supposed to be kind. And we're not supposed to be spreading, you know, all kind of gossip and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
We are supposed to be different.
Uh-huh. Anybody else?
And we can't make it in with dirty minds. And sometimes we might see something, maybe we think it's something we really saw. And we need to get closer to God.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't want to suffer, but Jesus suffered, so we shall suffer also.
Yes.
And so and things that we don't understand, we should ask the Lord for the understanding. And, and getting the word, it gives us knowledge and understanding. And to be with God, we have to be taught the word.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Anybody else?
And also, in 1 John chapter, chapter 1 and 2, is talking about the person and that which was from the beginning. And we know that God, He is the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
And He was also said that which we have heard. So they heard the word because in the beginning was the word. And God is the word and the word is God. So that which they had heard and that which they had seen with their own eyes, they could testify of what they saw with their own eyes. And our hands have handled all the word of life. And God is the word of life because His word gives us life. And verses 3 and 4, it tells us of the purpose. And that which we have seen, heard, declared, to declare it was to be there to witness it for themselves. And they, what they had declared, they was, you know, they was telling them what they had seen. And in order to have fellowship, you have to have a fellowship with God.
Mm-hmm.
And having that fellowship with John is a writer.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So John was letting them know they to have fellowship with them. And with that fellowship with them, and then that goes into the fellowship with Christ.
Mm-hmm.
And in that fellowship with Christ, the same joy that He's given them, John, He would give it to them.
Mm-hmm.
So fellowship and joy is a cultivation of the Spirit and the Word of God, so to say. And and also it talked about the conformity to a standard, and it talks about confession of sin that which is to say whatever sins we commit, we need to confess it. Because the scriptures say, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Confession is to say that I'm talking to God about everything that I've done or thought or said, and so, you know, for forgiveness of my sin. Because you can't hide your sin from God, because He knows all, He sees all, and He hears all.
Mm-hmm.
And God is light. That fifth verse here, God is light. He is a spirit, and He is love. So this light is His very nature.
Mm-hmm.
Holiness is the principal idea and lay the foundation for the Christian ethics of the letter.
All right. Anybody else? Where do we stop?
First 10.
Okay.
1 and 10.
Oh. We stopped at First John 1:10.
Mm-hmm. If he say we have not sinned, we make him what?
A lot.
A lot. For this cause God sent his Son into the world, that he may save us from our sins. Mm-hmm. Amen. Verse 1. Chapter 2, verse 1.
Okay. My little children, these things I write unto you, that ye sin not. And if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous.
My little children, these things write out to you, that ye, sin not, or that you may not what? Sin. Amen. And if any man sin, ye have what?
An advocate.
You have a
with the Father.
Amen. You have somebody that petitioning for you, mm-hmm. talking for you, speaking for you. Mm-hmm. But we have to go to him with it. We have to acknowledge our wrong. Amen.
Yes.
There's nothing wrong with acknowledging wrong.
No,
amen. How many of us know this?
Yes.
Amen. It doesn't make you any smaller. It doesn't make you any bigger. It's just that I realize I've done wrong, Lord, and I need your help.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Cleanse me from whatever I've done. Amen. We have an advocate with the Father, who is Jesus. Amen. He's our petitioner.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. As Satan comes to accuse us before God, Jesus is there to testify for us. Amen. As Satan come before God to accuse us, Jesus is there to testify for us. Amen. Read.
And he is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but often for the sins of the whole world.
Only Jesus can forgive sin. Only Jesus can forgive what? Sin. Amen. That's why he came. He came so that we might have a right to what? The tree of life.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And he's petitioning us for the whole what? World.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Even though the whole world might not come to him, but he yet they are waiting for them. Or he's waiting for us. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Acknowledge the problems. Acknowledge the issues. Amen. Don't come before God and say, I have done nothing wrong. Amen. I'm perfect. Amen.
Amen.
But come to him and allow him to know that you know. Because he already knows.
Yeah.
He already knows. Yeah. Acknowledge that you know I've done wrong. Amen. When I was growing up, whenever I would acknowledge things that I'd done, I didn't get a whooping.
That was smart.
Amen. But when I lied about it and tried to get away with it, I got a beat. Amen. How many remember that?
Yeah.
Amen.
So it is with God. When we acknowledge it, he heals us from whatever the problem is, and he dusts us off and sends us on our way. That ought to be some good news.
Amen.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
And unlike man, he does not hold against us what we have done wrong and acknowledge. He said, I cast it into the seal for what? Forgiveness.
Okay.
Never to be what? Remembered of what? Again. But we got to acknowledge. And that's the problem with the church. People don't want to acknowledge I'm wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. We have to learn to what? Acknowledge we what? We're wrong. Amen. Test of true knowledge, beginning in verse 3. True knowledge. Everybody don't have knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody don't have wisdom.
Amen.
Wisdom justifies her children. Everybody don't have wisdom. Amen. What is this?
And hereby we do know that we know him.
Hereby we do know that we do what?
Know
him. But there's got to be something there cause or allow us to know we know him. Amen. There's got to be some recognition on our part that testify that I know him. I didn't say know of him. I said know him. Amen. I'm not talking about hearing somebody else talk about him. I'm talking about you can talk about him. Why? Because you what? You know him. Amen. Mm-hmm. And hereby we do know that we know him.
If we keep his commandments.
If we keep his what? Mm-hmm. Commandment. It's not your opinion, it's not your thoughts, but it's his commandment. My ways are not your ways.
Neither my thoughts.
What? Your thoughts. We have to keep what? His commandment. His commandment. If we don't keep his commandment, we don't know him.
Amen.
Ah, Lord. Read.
He that saith, I know him, and keepeth not his commandment,
whoa,
is a liar.
Whoa.
And the truth is not in
whoa him. He that says what?
I know him.
And keepeth not his commandment is a
liar.
Oh, Lord.
That's the word.
And the truth is not in him. Knowledge is not in him. Knowledge is not in him. Love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, all thy soul, and all thy strength, and thy neighbor as thyself. If you don't keep his commandment, he's not in you. You're a liar, and the truth is not what in you. We got to learn to love everybody, even those that do you wrong. I can love you and not love your ways.
Mm-hmm.
How many of us know that?
Yeah.
Amen.
Let me say that again. I can love you and not love what? Your ways.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
God loves us and he don't love some of our ways.
That's right.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Read.
But whoso keepeth his word.
Whoso keepeth his word.
In him verily is the love of God perfected.
Verily in him is the love of God, what? Perfected. Whoso keepeth his what? His word. What is his word? What is his word?
His word is the gospel.
His word is the gospel. His word is God. It's whatever he says.
Yeah.
Whatever he says. You know, sometimes you buy a new refrigerator and it comes with a warranty. And then in that warranty, it explains what you have to do to that refrigerator for that refrigerator to make it. And if you don't do that, then your warranty is void.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, in these new refrigerators, they have a filter in it. And you have to change that filter every so often, every 6 months.
Really?
You have to change that filter. And that filter is about $77. Now, if that refrigerator tear up because you didn't change the filter, your warranty is null and what? Null. Why? Because you didn't keep their word. You didn't do what they said. What about God? If we don't do what God said, then our salvation is null and what? Null.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And to do what he said don't cost you $71. It's free. It's free. Mm-hmm. Somebody ought to shout hallelujah. Amen. But whoso keepeth the word, in him verily is the love of what? God perfected. Hereby know that we are what?
In him.
He deals with love.
Mm-hmm.
Love. That's a four-letter word we use, but we use it so casually.
Hmm.
Empty words. I love you, but do you?
Hmm.
Actions speaks louder than what?
Word.
Than word.
Mm-hmm.
In him is his love, what? Is the love of God perfected.
Mm-hmm.
I gotta love my enemies.
Mm-hmm.
I gotta love those that despitefully misuse me. I don't have to love their ways, but I have to love them. Hallelujah. Yes. Yes.
I guess I had that look on my face.
Yes. Gotta love everybody.
Uh-huh.
irregardless of their color, their race, their creed. You got to love everybody, even those who are living in sin, homosexuality. You got to love the person, but don't know what they're doing.
You got to love.
Got to love.
You have to ask Lord, give you that strength.
Gotta have it.
Yeah.
We have to have the love of God in us.
Yeah.
First to be able to love somebody else.
Yeah.
Amen. How many of us know this?
Amen.
When we don't have the love of God, we have that Phyllis love. Well, it has many conditions. Amen. The agape love don't have conditions. It love in spite of. Unconditional love. A Phyllis love is conditional.
Yeah.
And if you're still fine like you used to be.
Yeah.
What happens when you lose a leg? Lose an eye, get in a car wreck. See, agape love, love you if you don't have no leg.
That's right, pal.
Blind in one eye. Can't see out the other. Agape love, love what? In spite of. Amen. That's the kind of love we got to have. It's the kind of love we got to have. Now, do I have to put up with you in the ways you have that are not right? No. God don't even do it. God don't put up with our ways that he don't like.
Yeah.
He tell us to repent. Repent. Amen. Amen. Repent. How many of us know this? Verse 6.
He that said he abideth in him ought to himself also to walk even as he walked.
How did Jesus walk? I must work the work of him that sent me.
While
it is day. Night comes when what? No man can work. If I said I know Jesus, I'll be walking like him. I'll be thinking like him. I'll be talking like him. Oh my God.
Pastor. With that being said, how do I want to word this? We ought to walk like him is to say we know that Jesus is perfect. And, you know, people say sometimes I'm not perfect. We know that.
Mm-hmm.
None of us are perfect.
Mm-hmm.
That's why the scripture said man should always pray and not faint.
Uh-huh.
And we got to continue to pray, and we got to get deeper and deeper in the word.
Mm-hmm.
And the more we pray and the deeper we get in the word, that is to say that we are walking like Jesus walks.
Uh-huh. Now, you got to understand, I can be perfect in love.
Perfect love.
But not in deeds.
Indeed.
My deeds sometimes don't match up. How many of us get this? But I can be perfect in love. If I'm perfect in love, I love you in spite of it.
Okay.
And if I love you, I'm going to tell you when you're wrong.
Right.
How many of us know this?
Amen.
We ought to also walk as he walked. All right. Verse 7.
Brother. I write no new commandment unto you, but an old commandment which ye had from the beginning. The old commandment is the word which ye have heard from the beginning.
What you heard from the beginning. Jesus died, he rose, he ascended into heaven, and he's calling men to repentance. Mm-hmm. Paul said there was a time when God winked at this stuff. He don't wink at them no more. Amen. Because we should know better. We got something in us to tell us right from wrong.
The Spirit.
That Spirit what? The Spirit allows you to know when you're about to do something wrong.
Yeah.
I don't care who you are. If you got the Spirit in you, it'll let you know this wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Once it lets you know what you're going to do about it. We have to grow to the point that we can accept what the Spirit say and change.
Mm-hmm.
And change. For example, I used to do like everybody else. When I go to the grocery store, get my groceries out of that cart, I didn't care where I put it.
Yeah.
That was wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Spirit allowed me to know that was wrong. That's why I'm now, if it's raining, I don't care what it is, I'm going to push it in the spot that it belonged to me.
Right, yeah.
Because I wouldn't want that shopping cart to hit my car.
No.
and do unto others, and you have nothing to do unto you. You wouldn't want nobody to leave that shopping cart there and hit your car. So why do it to others? Amen. But they got to answer for that. I'm only responsible for me. Amen. I'm only responsible for what? For me. I'm going to get paid for what I do. Not what you do. That's why I constantly stress the fact that people ought to stay out of other folk's business. Because they're going to get paid for what they do. How many of us know this? Every decision I make, I got to answer to God for it, not you. And since I got to answer to God for it, I'm going to make sure it's my decision, not yours.
Yeah.
Somebody ought to shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In fact, that's one thing. If we could learn as Christians, we could be a better church. How many of us know this?
Right
now. Not being a busybody.
Busybody. Don't be a busybody. Don't mean what a fact. You don't know what's going on.
No, you don't.
Amen. And I don't even like to give my advice to people unless they ask.
Yeah.
Amen. You ask me, I'll tell you.
Yeah.
Amen.
But you can, you know, somebody that you really trust and, you know, and you can talk to them and tell them what's going on.
Uh-huh.
Knowing that it's not going any further.
Mm-hmm.
But I would tell anybody, I can only give you my opinion of it.
Uh-huh.
But it's you the one make the decision. You make your own choice, because I'm not going to be held accountable for telling you one thing, and if you do it, and it's going to fall back on me.
Mm-hmm.
So make your own choice and your own decision, and at the end of it, I say, God bless you.
Amen. But it is good to have somebody you can talk to.
Yeah, yeah.
But the ultimate decision has to be yours.
Yeah.
But you do need somebody that's going to talk to you and tell you the truth.
Yeah, yeah.
Amen.
Persuaded.
Because sometimes people standing on the outside can see better than you.
Yeah.
Because you're in it.
Amen.
When you're in a storm, it seems like that's the worst thing in the world, but other folks looking at it don't even face it.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So sometimes it's good to have somebody you can talk to that's going to tell you the truth. Don't get in the Word of God to tell you the truth.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about your opinion, I'm talking about getting into the Word of God. Sometimes, you know, folk tell me this and that, and what you think I'll do? Do what is right.
Mm-hmm.
That's the best answer you can give. Do what is right.
Yeah.
How many of us know that? Because sometimes people come for you to enforce wrongdoing.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Just tell them, do what's right.
Well, if I was you, I'd just go ahead and shoot at them or shoot them and all that kind of stuff, but you are not me.
No. Mm-hmm. Do what is right is your best answer.
That's the best one.
Yes. All right. Verse 8.
Again, a new commandment I write unto you, which thing is true in him and in you.
Because that is, if he's in you. It's true in him and in what? And you, if he's in you, come on.
Because the darkness is past and the true light now shines.
Because the darkness is passing. Mm-hmm. Passing away. We don't come to Jesus and overnight all the darkness is gone.
Mm-hmm. It's a process.
Growing process.
One day a week thing. It's an everyday thing.
It's a process. We're coming right out of this darkness.
Yeah.
You know, once you get saved, you still got some crazy things in your mind.
Uh-huh. Yes, Lord.
How many of us know this?
Satan's got to be working on you.
He's still working on you. Amen. And he keeps stuff in your mind.
Mm-hmm.
But we're overcoming. That's why Jesus said, as I have overcome the world, you also must overcome. Which means that's an ongoing process. Ongoing process.
Mm-hmm.
And I like the illustration that you got a car that always gives you trouble. Sooner or later, you're going to get tired of it,
mm-hmm.
or get rid of it and get you another.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. That's the way this life is. You know, things keep coming back. Sooner or later, you're going to get tired of it. You're going to ask God, Lord, deliver me from this.
Mm-hmm.
And when you ask him, you mean it.
Yes.
Because why? Because you're tired.
Yes.
Sometimes we ask God to deliver us from stuff that we ain't tired of yet.
And he don't work
until
he tells you.
Amen. And that's why things are not changing, because you're not what? Tired of it.
Yes.
Anybody ever been tired of something, ask God to deliver you, and he delivered you?
Oh, yes. I was just saying it in my mouth, and that really, you know, really what I wanted in my heart and in my mind, mm-hmm. did nothing happen.
Amen.
But when I got sincere and true, asked the Lord to remove it.
Amen.
He did it just like that.
They said, an alcoholic don't need counseling until he gets ready to quit.
That's right.
He's got to make up his mind he won't quit.
That's it.
I don't care who talked to him. I don't care where they go. If your mind ain't made up, you can't do it.
The police can't do it. The judge can't do it.
Amen.
You got the wrong to do it no more.
Verse 9.
He just said he is in the light and hating his brother.
Wait a minute. You mean I can say I'm in the light and then hate my brother? Mm. Is that possible?
Can't do it.
He that says he's in the light and hateth his brother. Read. As evil is in darkness, even until now. You're still in darkness.
Even tonight.
You hate your brother, you're still in darkness. Mean you're insane. When you're saved, you can't hate people.
Amen.
Why? Because the love of God is in you. And I go to stress this point. You can dislike a person way, but you can't hate them. What if God had hated you? Mm-hmm. We've had some ways that he didn't like, but he didn't hate. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, even when we didn't deserve it.
That's right.
And just like he loves us, we have to love others. We have to love others.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, that was hard to me.
Oh, it's not really hard. You just got to give it to God.
Yeah, but you know, it was, I'm saying it was hard for me because it was getting worse in me.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't like the way I was feeling because I thought about it. Well, I prayed about it. And God didn't answer that prayer. And when I thought about it, I said, you know, I don't like what I'm feeling because it came to me that I was almost hating.
Mm-hmm.
And when I realized that, well, the Spirit had spoke to me. And I had got to that point. But I didn't get deep in it, and when I realized it,
mm-hmm.
I prayed, and I was on my way home from church one Sunday, and I was just driving, and I didn't know why I was crying,
mm-hmm.
and when the Spirit was still dealing with me, and I was driving and crying, and I was just screaming out in the car,
mm-hmm.
and I realized that I poured my heart out to God,
mm-hmm.
and when I poured my heart out to him, that's when he worked it for me, and I didn't even know it that Sunday until I had almost made it to the house when mm-hmm. he spoke to me, and that was a burden left off me, and that was a feeling that I never felt before, and I tell you, and he gave me joy to know, because I mean, I was just in the car, just crying out to him, just screaming in the car and driving.
Uh-huh.
And I said, God had to be with me because he kept me in my lane.
Amen. Amen. Hate brings about bitterness.
Yes, I was there.
You know, and people that hate, you can see it all. Mm-hmm.
Yes, you can.
You can see it all.
They have a miserable look.
Amen. Amen. Sometimes you can be hurt so bad that you almost hate.
I was there.
Amen. And I mean, it'll get down in you, and the only something can get it out is God.
Yes, yes.
Anybody ever been there?
Been there.
Amen. Yes. Lord, take this out of me. This ain't right, Lord. And it's got me miserable.
Yeah.
People that hate is miserable.
Yes, it eats them up. I mean.
And I refuse to be miserable.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
It eats them up. at people that hate pastors, and they look miserable. You don't never see them smile.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's just something about that countenance that I mean, you can just see it.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Listen, verse 10.
He that loveth his brother abideth in the light, and there is none occasion of stumbling in him.
He that loveth his brother abideth in the light, and there is none occasion of stumbling in him. When you love the brethren, then God can use you. God can talk to you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when somebody come by with something that's wrong, God will let you know that ain't right.
Mm-hmm.
But when you hate,
mm-hmm.
there's no room for God to speak.
None.
There's no room for God to even help you.
Mm-hmm.
When you hate, there are folks on the crazy floor because they had so much hate in them that it ate them up. My God. Lord, don't let no hate come into me.
Yeah.
I don't want no hate.
Ooh,
verse 11.
But he that hateth his brother is in darkness.
He that hateth his brother ain't saved.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't saved.
No.
This is the test of whether or not we're saved. Do you hate anybody? And that means sisters too. Do you hate anybody?
No.
If you hate some people, then you ain't saved. You're in darkness.
Mm-hmm.
You're in darkness. But he that hateth his brother is in what? Darkness.
Mm-hmm. And walketh in darkness.
Mm-hmm.
And knoweth not whither he goes.
Walketh in darkness. He comes to trying to figure out a way to get at that person that he hated.
Mm.
You know, I've heard people say, I knew it was going to happen sooner or later. Somebody done wrong, something happened to that person. I knew that was going to happen sooner or later. Listen, you got that much hate in you that you're watching folks to fall, watching folks to be hurt, and yet shout on Sundays? Come on now. And the church has got to be clean. Church got to be clean. It got to be clean if we're gonna live for Jesus. Are we helping anybody?
Amen.
Walk in the darkness and knoweth
whither he goeth. Because that darkness had blinded his eyes.
Because the darkness had blinded his eyes. Or her eyes. You don't know where you're going.
Mm-hmm.
Because the darkness. You turn the lights out in here right now. And even though we know what the pews are, we're going to trip over something.
Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I sure would.
Huh?
Mm-hmm.
Because you're walking in what? In darkness. Amen. A lot of people are tripping because they're walking in darkness. Them people that was in Times Square waiting on Jesus to come back because some man said it, were walking in darkness. Because had they had the light, they would understand. When Jesus comes back, the dead in Christ shall rise first. And those that are alive remain shall be caught up to be with the Lord. But they're walking in what? It's easier to be misled when you're walking in darkness.
Because there was no counsel that nobody know when he comes back.
Nobody knows. Nobody knows. Amen. If Jesus said he didn't know,
what
made you think a man know?
That's what I'm talking about.
God ain't going to tell a man what he didn't tell Jesus. But we're walking what? In darkness.
Mm-hmm.
Walking in darkness. Read.
I write unto you, little children, because your sins are forgiven you for his name's sake.
For his name's sake.
Yeah.
For his name's sake. All my sins are forgiven for his name's sake. No other name on the heaven for my name might be saved except the name Jesus. And because of him, his name's sake, my sins are what? Forgiven. My sins are forgiven. And that's enough to shout about right there.
Yeah.
He could have allowed us to die and go to hell.
Mm-hmm.
But yet he forgave our sins. How many of y'all know you've been forgiven?
Amen.
Lift your hands and thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
It could have been somebody else other than you or other than me.
Yes.
I thank you.
Me too.
I say I thank you.
Oh, yeah. Every day.
Mm-hmm.
Read.
fathers, because you have known him that is from the beginning. I write unto you, young men, because ye have overcome the wicked woman.
Ye have overcome what?
The wicked
woman. The wicked woman. I'm going to look up in church today. Somebody had to overcome the wicked woman. I'm glad I have.
All right. Amen.
Is you glad?
Yes, Lord.
Read.
I write unto you, little children, because ye have known the Father.
Come on.
I have written unto you, fathers, because ye have known him that is from the beginning.
You have known him that is from what? The beginning, which is Jesus. Anytime we know Jesus, it changes our life. It changes our thought process.
Mm-hmm.
Amen? When I was in the world, done wrong, I got evil. Now I put it in God's hand. I put it in God's hand. How many putting it in God's hand? Lord, you take it. You can do more with it than I can.
That's it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
I have written unto you, young men, because you are strong, and the word of God abideth in you, and ye have overcome the wicked one.
The word of God what abideth in you? I don't understand people who say they know Jesus, but yet no Bible study and no Sunday school. That's why the devil have such a strong hold in the church. You're cleansed through what? The word. You're cleansed through the word. If you don't have the word, there's no healing. That's why sometimes we're standing in that line for prayer for the same thing over and over again, because we don't have no word. When you got word, you can get healed. If you abide in me, my word abide in you, you shall ask what you will, and it shall be. And the word of God abides in you, and you have overcome the devil. The devil. You've overcome him. Amen. He can't puff me like he used to. He can't do me like he used to. Oh my God. Oh, it's a wonderful feeling when you get to the point the devil can't buff you like he used to. I've often said, I thank God for self-control. When you overcome, that devil, God give you self-control. And no matter what that devil throw at you, you will not tear down your testimony because of what he threw. You let God deal with it. He know how to deal with it. How many of us know this?
Amen.
Verse 15.
Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him.
Love not the world. Don't love what's in this world. Some folk love it so much, love the world so much, they can't stay away from parties and all this other stuff, but they can stay away from church.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because they love what? The world more than they do God.
Yeah.
They love the world more than they do God. I can't wait till Wednesday night for Bible study. I can't wait for Sundays for them to come out here and praise God with the brothers and sisters. How many feel like me?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Ain't nothing else like it. When you come to the house of God and give God praise together.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Love not the world, neither the things that are what?
In the world.
In the world. Everything in this world is going to dissolve.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to burn up with fire. Mm-hmm. If any man love the world, he hadn't been born again. Oh, taste and see.
That the Lord is
good. Or we have tasted and seen that the Lord is good, then the world means absolutely nothing to us anymore. Hallelujah. Love not the world. Love not the world. You think that in the world. Any man that loves the world, the love of the Father, is not in him. Verse 16.
For all that is in the world.
The lust of the flesh, fulfilling the desires of your flesh. Let me say that again. Fulfilling the desires of your flesh.
When we fulfill the desires of our flesh, we get in trouble. How many of us know this? The lust of the flesh.
And the lust of the eyes.
The lust of the eyes. Whatever we see, we want. Whatever we see, we what? That's the way he got to eat. That's the way that devil got to eat, through the eye. Had a look at it. And got him in trouble. And what? The pride of what? Life.
The life is not of the Father, but is of the world.
It's not of the Father, but is of the world. Humble yourself. Humble yourself. Pride won't allow you to humble yourself. Let me say that again. Pride will not allow you to humble yourself. When you think more of yourself than you ought to, it will not allow you to humble yourself. No matter what you're doing, you ought to thank God he allowed you to do it.
Amen.
And then instead of thinking you big enough to do it. Whatever I do is because God allowed me to do it. And I thank him for it. Amen. When he uses me, I thank him for it.
Yeah.
He could have used somebody else.
Amen.
Oh, God. It's a wonderful feeling when God uses you.
Yeah.
Paul said it's so wonderful. He said, I'm a slave. I'm a slave to God. Hallelujah. Verse 17.
And the world passes away.
And the world passes away.
And the lust thereof.
And the lust thereof.
But he that doeth the will of God abideth well.
But he that doeth the will of God abideth. The world passes away. And the lust, things that your flesh desires, is going to pass away. The things your flesh desires is going to what? Pass away. But he that abideth, who he that doeth the will of God abideth forever. Abideth forever. Now, he says we shouldn't hate our brothers. We shouldn't walk in darkness. We should keep God's commandments. How many of us get this? Amen. We should love the world. The lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, pride of life, is things that we should get rid of. The meek shall inherit the earth, not those that got pride.
Yeah.
He said, you need to do all this because you need to understand the Antichrist is coming. Antichrist is coming. Verse 18.
And as ye have heard that Antichrist shall come, even now are there many Antichrists, whereby we know that it is the last time.
Listen, he said, if you want to judge what time you're living in, he said, Antichrist will come. These are the last time, the last hour. This is the last hour. And as ye have heard that Antichrist shall come, even now, even in John's day, are there many Antichrists. We got a whole bunch of them now. David Koresh said he was Jesus. And wearing eyeglasses.
So that was
David Koresh said he was Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
And he wearing eyeglasses. Got folk killed. Him too. Antichrist. Antichrist. Amen. Whereby we know that it is the last time. Now verse 19 is very interesting.
They went out from us.
They went out from us. Not everybody that joined this church is a part of us. That's why you need to stop latching on the people and latch on to Jesus.
Amen.
Not everybody come here is of us. In this in y'all Bible. They went out from us, and then when they go out from you, they lie on you, they talk about you, but they can't damage you because God is on your side. And if God be for you, who can be
against
you? They went out from us.
But they were not of us.
But they were not of us.
For if they had been of us.
If they had been of us, the devil in hell couldn't talk them out of here. Just like God planned his people, the devil planned his. But those that are saved have to get to the point where you can see and discern what is wrong. Amen. For if they had been of us, they would no doubt have continued with us. Mm-hmm.
But they went out that they might be made manifest that they were not all of us.
They went out that they might be manifested that they were not all of us. Stop latching on the people. Latch on to Jesus. Mm-hmm. Because it's not a cinch that they're going to still be here. But God is here always. Love people, but don't latch on to people. How many of us getting this? Because just because they come here don't mean they're going to stay. What amazes me is those that have come and said, God sent them here. And a month later, so he must send them somewhere else. God don't operate that way. When God puts you in a place, you got to weather the storm. And there's going to be some storms.
Oh, yeah.
There's going to be some suffering.
Yeah.
But you got to weather the storm and the suffering if God planted you there. Because if you look up our perfect church,
you ain't gonna find
got news for you. Mm-hmm. You won't find it.
Mm-hmm. Sure. No, no, no perfect church.
In fact, all the churches are having problems now. My God. It's time to get out of here. They went out. They were not all of what? Not all of us. In fact, Nebo don't hinge on the ones that left. It hinges on the ones that stayed. Y'all missed it.
I know what you got.
It does not hinge on the ones that left. It hinges on the ones that stayed. Because the one that stayed, even the devil can't talk them out. Because they know. My sheep knows my voice. And a stranger,
they will not follow.
Mm-hmm. Let's get ready to go home. Oh, and that's some good word.
Yes, it is.
Stop latching on to people. Latch on to Jesus.
That's it.
Hallelujah. People will let you down.
All the time.
But God never will. Latch on to him. In fact, he's jealous.
Yes,
when you start latching on to people that are not to him, he's jealous.
He said he's a jealous God.
I better well know this.
Yeah. Amen.
He
said he's a jealous God.
Any questions before we go?
So that's the with latching on to people. Is to say that you put more stock in people rather than God.
Rather than God.
And you look at the fact the more latches on, the more friends you have, so to say.
Mm-hmm.
But then you're not looking at the full picture.
Not looking, you don't see the full picture, because then they're not your friend.
They're not your friend.
So I got to latch on to you for you to be my friend. You ain't my friend.
Yeah, because then they know that you my friend, and with you being my friend, you going to listen, and we going to come together, we going to come to an agreement that we're going to go here, we're going to go there, we're going to do this, and we're going to do that.
Mm-hmm.
But it's never about, let's go to church.
Yes.
And you look at the fact that those that's running with the friends,
are the ones that's up to no good.
Amen. For an example, we had a preacher that came to Nebo, and he talked about how many churches he had built and all this stuff, and then discovered he was running from the law.
Oh yeah, I remember him.
Amen. For molesting a child. But yet Nebo last time.
I didn't.
Hallelujah. When you guys got the Spirit of God, you go get to discern when something ain't right.
I thought he was gay. I did
know
he was gay.
Well, I didn't have a good feeling because Maddie was the one who told me to give him a chance to get to know him. I said, it just something ain't right.
Let every man prove himself.
That's a common somebody to prove.
Thank you for your angels, oh God, that's watching over us, oh God.
All right.
Thank you for your goodness, Heavenly Father.
Thank you for
your love. Just thank you for everything.
Yeah.
Thank you for life, oh God. We just, everything that we have now, oh God, we just say thank you. Knowing that it was because of you, Heavenly Father.
Yeah.
Because of the love that you have for us, you gave your only begotten Son.
Mm-hmm.
Heavenly Father, thank you for your word.
Thank you for the teaching of your word.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for opening the hearts and the minds to receive your word.
Mm-hmm.
And in receiving your word, oh God, receiving it glad.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Heavenly Father, we pray that you will shine your light upon us, Heavenly Father, that you will bring us all out of darkness, oh God.
Mm-hmm.
Bring us into your marvelous light.
Mm-hmm.
We need your light, Heavenly Father.
All right.
We need you, Heavenly Father, to lead us and guide us.
Mm-hmm.
We know, Heavenly Father, time is not long as it has been.
Yeah.
We just don't know, Heavenly Father, but we pray, oh God, that you would keep us in your hands.
Right.
Keep your loving arms around us, keeping us safe from all hurt, harm, and danger.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Heavenly Father, pray and ask that you would keep Satan away,
knowing
that he came to kill, to steal, and to destroy.
Yes.
And he's going to and fro right now, oh God. He's going up and down, Heavenly Father.
Mm-hmm.
He's gathering souls at a speed now. You just have to look up and say, Lord, have mercy on us.
Yes.
Have mercy, Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Those that are sincere, you know our hearts, Heavenly
Yes.
Father.
Right.
Those that are pretending, oh God, you know their hearts as well.
Yes.
Heavenly Father, we pray that you will strengthen us and keep us.
Yes.
Lisa.
We pray, oh God, that you would keep your merciful hands upon our pastor.
Yes.
And we pray that, oh God, you keep your merciful hands upon every man of God
mm-hmm.
that you have chosen, that you have called, you have anointed, appointed, and ordained.
Mm-hmm.
They are the ones that's teaching your word, oh God.
Right.
In your word, you said, feed my sheep.
Yes.
They are feeding the sheep, Heavenly Father.
Amen.
Knowing that in the midst, there are some goats there too, Heavenly Father.
Yes. Yes. Right.
Pray, oh God, that you would just strengthen them
in
their daily walk with you, oh God.
Mm-hmm.
Keeping them, Heavenly Father. Giving them that wisdom and knowledge more and more to teach and to preach your word.
Mm-hmm.
Regardless, that's what the people say, oh God.
Yeah,
they are doing your will and not the will of the people.
Mm-hmm.
Heavenly Father, as long as you are satisfied with them,
mm-hmm.
that's all that matters, oh God.
All right.
Keep them, oh God.
Please,
it is time for us to leave this place, oh God. We pray that you would keep us all safe from all hurt, harm, and danger.
Mm-hmm.
Those that are already on the roads and the highways, oh God. Keeping every man and woman on their sides of the road, oh God.
Mm-hmm.
Let them pay attention to what's going on.
All
and get us to our immediate destination safely, oh God. It was thy holy will. And keep us throughout the night and early morning, however your will is, oh God. It's your will.
All right.
And we know that it's going to be done.
Mm-hmm.
It is in Jesus' name we pray.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Lord, we thank you.
Amen. Amen.